Okay, what's going on, everybody? It is your boy Crypt here, and today I'm going to be breaking down the lyrics of my DAX diss, and then I don't want to talk about this anymore! No, I'm just fucking around. I can talk about it every fucking day of my life. I have fun with this shit. So Chase just left my house like an hour ago. He's been staying with me for the last week, and thank fucking God he's finally gone. I can finally make a video and masturbate and everything else. I'm just kidding, bro. I love you. But I've seen a lot of reactions, and I've seen a lot of people talk about the diss tracks. Thank you for everyone who has reacted to this. There's just been so many, way more than I thought. I'm gonna try to put all you guys in a playlist, like a reactions playlist, and put it on my channel if you guys want to go check those out. But the thing with this diss, man, is that I tried to be so intricate with it and so many jabs that only DAX would know, and a lot of people don't really know like some of the stuff that I was talking about. And Screw said it best, like, you find more and more stuff each time that you listen to it. So I really took like a kill shot approach with this. Like, I didn't want to make something like crazy catchy. I wanted something like that DAX knew what I was talking about, and like certain stuff that would like literally hit him. And like, the more times you listen to it, you find new stuff over and over again. So I'm gonna go through this diss track. I'm gonna talk a little bit about the behind the scenes stuff. I might even post some bloopers at the end, because I know a lot of people were wanting to see those bloopers. But I will go over it bar for bar and let you guys know my thoughts whenever I was making this, and like the punchlines I was going for and stuff like that. And yeah, that's what we're doing today. So I'm glad to be making videos again. I've got some new songs coming out. Go down to the description. I got a song coming out with Vinjay dropping next Friday. It's called The Devil Went Down to Hip Hop. It's a crazy fucking song. It's available for pre-order and pre-save down there in the description. Like I said, it'll be out next Friday. I've also got another song in the works with a girl named Lex, and she is fucking badass. Raps better than I do. I don't know when that's coming out, but we just got done recording that like 2 days ago. She also came down here. It's just been a crazy fucking week, okay? I've had Screw, Chase, Dwayne TV, Lex has been down here. Like 2 weeks ago, I had Vinjay, Jake, his cameraman, and No Life Shack. And then like in a week and a half, I'm going to Colorado to do some more videos with people. It's just wild right now. But that's enough of that. Let's get to the behind the scenes and the breakdown. And you guys can hear it from the horse's mouth about some of this shit. So here we go. Okay. So, funeral music playing in the background. Which is...
I'm sorry you never found Bart.
It's fine though. I heard he was a janitor.
Release his hands ain't moving.
Those can be worse.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. All right,
okay, bye-bye. So this whole scene was just hilarious. This is probably the 12th time we did this scene. Each time somebody said something different. Dwayne started off with saying, I'm sorry you never found Bart, in the reference to the Sideshow Bob thing from The Simpsons. Chase says, I heard he was a janitor. And the Screw was talking about the DAX Hands Challenge. He said, at least his hands ain't moving. Like, guys, you have no idea how many times we laughed at this. And, like, I could not keep my composure the first time I heard some of these guys' jokes, because I had no idea what people were going to say. And then, like, the running joke behind this whole thing is that we were going to say that DAX had gummy worm hairs, because I found some gummy worms that looked exactly like his hair. So I reached in, I was like, are those gummy worms? And I went to go bite it, and then Dwayne stopped me. It was a massive setup from the beginning to the end. Like, we wanted you to keep that in your mind. Whenever I was making this, like, the music video is another diss in and of itself. There's, like, the song with all the disses, then there's the music video, which has separate shots and separate disses. Also, if you notice right there, there's a fucking chainsaw. It's the blanket of his casket. Like, right here is a chainsaw. It's the exact chainsaw he used in his whack ass rapper's diss track, and it's an electric chainsaw. If you look really close, right there is the plug. That's now plugged in. What's this so funny? Okay.
Started. Let's get started. Let's keep going over there.
And there's some more shit later on too that I'll try not to pause too much.
What is good, my friends?
That's Dwayne's intro. Also, you can see the Thanos glove in the coffin back here.
We are here today for the eulogy of DAX.
Dodge is a bitch!
Oh god, that was
hey,
so funny.
Hold up, guys. This man was a living legend. Don't you remember that time that he gave us a free feature and he helped promote a song too?
No.
Ah, yeah. So funny.
Oh, you're right. Yeah.
Okay, so that scene's pretty self-explanatory. You can see that we have a cutout of DAX's face on there. We didn't really know what to do. I had a guy that looked very similar to DAX that I was going to put in the coffin, like do his hair up just like DAX. But the funeral home told us we weren't allowed to put a body in this casket because it's a rental casket. So there's been actual dead people inside of this casket right here, which really freaked me the fuck out. Not even going to lie.
Sorry about that.
With that said, we have a couple people who could not make it that did want to send some kind words, so we're going to show them for you guys on the TV right here. I'd like to give a shout out to Grizzy Hendrix and Hi Rez for sending these messages through.
I always knew it, man. I mean, what can I say about DAX, man? What can I say about DAX that the world doesn't already know? He comes from humble beginnings, man. I mean, he always made big plays.
The comedy.
Before he actually became...
Okay, so fun fact about this is that I didn't get the clip from Hi Rez or Grizzy Hendrix until the day after the shoot, so I had to, like, mask it and make it look like it was on the TV.
what he's widely recognized as today is as the second Tupac. But
nobody's fucking paying attention at the funeral.
Wearing a shirt right now.
Dude, I was so happy when Hi-Rez sent me this clip. We were all sitting at dinner at my house the day after the shoot.
Fuck you, Dex.
Same thing, man.
Does anybody else have anything to say?
Yeah, I guess I'm the one to say. All
right, the floor is yours.
Oh, that beat, man. Okay, so that's Dax's ex-girlfriend, Kendra. Those are some flowers, which were her favorite flowers. And this is also a note that she left him. It's not an actual tweet or anything. At least I don't think it is. We just found some, like, really hurtful stuff that maybe she might say to him. Okay, so there's KSI. There's a plunger from the YouTube creators, from the YouTube reactors and creators. It's a funeral arrangement. In the middle of it is a big fucking plunger. Okay, the undrafted thing I'll talk about in a minute. Time for Dax. Welcome to Dax's eulogy. He practically passed the news to me. This is what happens when you get confused and shoot at the two. Okay, so first of all, you could see in the background, people were just laughing their ass off because they had no idea the guys behind me were going to be dancing the way they were. They were doing like some Temptations jazz move dances and shit. I didn't know they were going to do it either, so it was really cool to see it in post. I couldn't see these guys dancing behind me, obviously. But pretty much the opening line is, welcome to Dax's eulogy. He practically passed the noose to me. This is what happens when you get confused and shoot at a truancy. So the first line, he practically passed the noose to me, is a double meaning. It can be noose as in like rope, he hung himself, or a news as in he passed me the news that he's already dead. Like, he dissed me and basically gave me the news that I'm already going to kill him. So it's a double entendre with that. And then I said, this is what happens when you get confused and shoot at a truancy. And whack-ass rappers, he said he put all of us in a headshot and, like, you know, did the little shot emoji or shot motions at all of us. So that was a stab at that. Who's this dude think he's fooling? He's just fueling me stupidly. Yes, it's true, since you used an extra year to get that school degree. We both graduated back in 2013. But you're a year older. I guess it was harder than it seemed. What's harder don't honor your mindset. Okay, I gotta stop it right there because that's a line. Dax is a full year older than me, actually a year and a half older than me, but we both graduated high school the exact same year. Dax stayed an extra year of high school because his senior year he did not get picked up by any colleges, so he wanted to stay an extra year at his private high school so he could get college basketball offers. Bitch! Must be Token, that's spiceless. This bitch is diss left me bored to death, for Christ's sake! Shout out Token. I said it must be Token, that spiceless. This bitch is diss left me bored to death, for Christ's sake. And Token's song YouTube Rappers, which is with Tech9, which is a whole stab of it in and of itself. Basically, we're YouTube rappers and I reference Tech9 and all that other stuff. I said bored to death, you know, because Jesus was crucified on the cross. He was bored to death. And I'm saying Dax's diss on us just left me so bored because it wasn't a diss. And again, saying he's Token, that spice lace. Spice is a drug, but it was laced, so it really just fucked his head up. That's all, you know, that's speculations and shit. But the way he acts like he's on fucking drugs. So I heard you had some words for me written down in the scheme. 5 months after the fact, let's recap to see what he means. He trashed me behind my back. He half-assed his verse on my track, even though I gave him the cash that he asked for to make the rap. Okay, so that scene right there, people in the audience had no clue I was going to be interacting with him, and honestly, I didn't either. We did a scene, like, we had shot all of it, and the guys were like, you need to go to the back of the congregation and, like, slowly turn around and just start rapping. And when I slowly turned around and started, I just had the idea to just start interacting with the crowd. So I was, like, going up, tapping people on the shirt, like, talking to them, like, interacting with them, and everybody was, like, freaking out, had no clue. So that was funny. But basically, that whole scheme right there was just me reiterating why I don't like Dax. How he half-assed his verse on Four Horsemen, even though I gave him the money that he wanted to, and then started talking shit behind my back and things like that. And then I put his ass on blast for being fake. Is his chain that said Dax? Now he's aiming my way, claiming I attacked. What is that? Dax's chain that said Dax was fake. I have confirmation. Damn right I did. This a walk in the park. And I'm supposed to beg a shit lift my bitches, so let the carnage start. Okay, that line, I know I'm going to be pausing a lot, but there's just a lot of hidden little stuff like that. Sorry, my phone's going off. I don't know if it's different for everybody else, but the parks around here, when you go for a walk in the park and you take your dog and they shit on the ground, you're supposed to bag up the shit. So I said, I'm supposed to bag up shit left by bitches. So I'm saying Dax is a bitch. Bitch is another term for a female dog, and saying his diss track was shit. So I'm bagging it up and I'm taking out the trash. You tweeting me, telling me that I gotta go see what Dax said. So like you, I had to take a little peep. Obviously, double meaning on the little peep situation where he took the little peep verse after he died and shit. What did I see? A bunch of sheep counted so much I fell asleep. Someone tell this beat when you diss me, don't do so carelessly. Again, that's another like double meaning thing. I was saying like whenever I saw his diss, there were so many people commenting saying that he burned us alive, even though he didn't fucking diss us. I was calling them sheep because they just follow him and whatever he does. But I was, you know, it's another thing. Like I said, I've counted so many sheep that it made me fall asleep. Because when you try to fall asleep, they say count sheep. So like one sheep, two sheep, three sheep, and you just keep counting sheep, and you eventually fall asleep. It's an old wives' tale. So that's what that was about. Now I think about it, it's funny how we all sleep. Dax with his painted toes tucked up under his sheets, cuddled up with bundles of money, he's scared for run some beats. His Dax sleeps with everyone and all of y'all sleeping on me. I love that, man. So there's just many different forms on the sleep thing, saying that Dax sleeps with his painted toes tucked up under his sheets. Dax paints his toenails, which is funny in and of itself, but saying that he was cuddled up with all the money that he scammed for on some beats. Dax made like over $10,000 in 2 months off of features that he just completely shitted on and like half-assed and shit. Which is nothing compared to his monthly revenue, so I don't even know what the fuck he was doing at the time. But then saying that his ex sleeps with everyone, just kind of a stab at the she cheated stuff and like the whole stigma that he put on her that she's a cheater. But then saying that everybody's sleeping on me because so many people of Dax's fan base were like, I'm just a fat white dude and I don't know how to rap. And they kind of, a lot of them changed their mind with this. A lot of them are still fucking dumbass sheep, but we'll just keep going. That's mad, I ain't accept this fake apology. Acting like I'm Tory Lanez the way he said I'm sorry, G. Okay, hold on, you see that? You see that? The big play chain? The sorry for your loss, G, from Tory Lanez? Bro, that's just dope. And there's a fucking toilet brush in the middle of it. That shit's funny. Said he wants to make a makeup track with me and screw, but I told him screw you, I don't fuck with you, dude. Okay, I've seen some reactions where people like didn't even know what the fuck this was talking about. And actually, this little text message right here, I didn't actually get a shot of it. I wish I did. But this text message is showing that he apologized to me back after the whole situation broke out. And he didn't apologize to me until well after he had been exposed by everyone else. And he knew he was in the wrong and was just being a dick about it. But basically text me, said sorry for the miscommunication. Didn't say sorry for half-assing the verse or talking shit behind my back or anything. And then he asked if we could do a makeup track with me and Screw. And he's like, it could fucking blow up. It'd be legendary. And I basically told him, go fuck yourself. I told him, I'm not going to do that. I've seen how you are. I'm going to pass on that. Which is honestly why I feel like Dax is so upset with me that I didn't just immediately fall back into it and like do what he wanted. Because I have morals and integrity, so go fuck yourself. So yeah, and I have screenshots to prove that. I might put that up on the screen, but it is printed out right there. But Dax did fake apologize to me, and I rejected his offer to make a makeup song. Said he was praying for my family when my grandmother died. Posted in my comments 2 weeks after her soul went to fly. Acting like it's a saint to get grace in the public eye. But they said shit to me and had my number the entire time. Okay, so that bar right there, if you're not familiar with the situation, whenever my grandmother died January 25th, which is a couple days after I released Four Horsemen with Dax. And that's all around the same time that all the shit was coming out that he was talking shit behind my back. So it was a really shitty time in my life. 2 weeks go by, I didn't make any music. I didn't do anything on YouTube. I was like really fucked up. But my first song back was Bad Habit, which was the subliminal diss against Dax. I mean, I threw a couple lines at him, but it was like my first song back trying to get back into YouTube and shit. And a lot of people were tagging Dax saying that it was about him. And Dax had the fucking nerve to comment on that video saying, I'm sorry for your loss. And then I'm praying for your family, and I hope all is well. Keep doing your thing, bro. And it was literally over 2 weeks after my grandmother died. And Dax has my number. We had talked many times through text, and he just never said anything to me. So the fact that he commented on the video that was a subliminal diss about him trying to look good in the public eye is literally what makes me hate Dax. Like, that is the whole thing. Like, I can get over him talking shit behind my back because people do that. It just shows your bitchness of a character. But when he does that, like, it's like personal shit about my grandmother and my family and trying to look good in the public eye over that. That is why I will never be cool with Dax. That's why I will never want to do anything with him. And that's why I will continuously shit all over him every single chance I get, because he is a piece of shit, and that right there just shows it. Obvious punchline. Okay, so I mean, some of these punchlines are pretty obvious. Get him a CAT scan because his pussy's brain needs some help. Cats are pussies. There are other words. CAT scan is when they examine your brain to see what the fuck is going on with your brain. Funny how I'm the fat man, but you're the one full of himself because he's egotistical. Another double meaning stuff right there. You want to say your freestyles are off the dome and it's lame. The only thing undrafted you when you went for the NBA. So a lot of people are not catching that one because I guess it was mixed kind of weird and the words blended together. But it said, you want to say your freestyles are off the dome and that's lame. The only thing undrafted is you when you went for the NBA. So basically saying that his freestyles aren't off the dome like he claims they are. They're obviously not off the dome. And, you know, Dax declared for the NBA draft back in 2017, which you have to have an agent to do, and he went undrafted after, like, 40 fucking rounds. So that was just a stab at him saying he's a really good basketball player when he didn't get drafted at all. And, like, when you write stuff down, it's called drafting, so... when it's undrafted, it means it's off the dome. He didn't get drafted. He's undrafted. That's what that meant. Say you're better than me like it is a brag and a boast. But we've been on two tracks together. I got rapped, you won them both. We were together on Four Horsemen. We were together on Unforgivable. And I had the better rhyme schemes and the better punchlines and all that shit on both of those songs. I mean, he did really good on Unforgivable with his melody and stuff that he fucking reused in My Last Words. Not even just the melody. He reused like two bars of that too. But if you go back and look at disses and punchlines, I had the better disses and punchlines in that right there. But Four Horsemen, hands fucking down. Like, not even a question. Let's talk about all these verses you reuse and thinking you're hard. But someone so fit, you sure are fucking lazy with the bars. Easy punchline. Name of your diss and acting like it's OG. But homie, we know that Daniel likes to steal low key. Okay, so a lot of people don't even know about this one. I didn't find this one out until, like, midway making this diss track. So Dax, obviously the diss on us was called Whack Ass Rappers. The instrument, or the increments, fuck, the acronym was called WAR, W-A-R. 4 years ago, he was working on a song with a guy named Steal Low Key, which is his YouTube channel, and the song was called WAR. Whack Ass Rappers. So I'm saying you stole the name of your diss, Whack Ass Rappers War, and acted like it's OG. But homie, we know that Daniel, which is his real name, likes to steal low key. So Steal Low Key is the name of the YouTube channel, and it's spelled differently, but saying he likes to steal low key, like steal the name of the diss on the low. And obviously, yeah, screws a fucking nut for this.
What are you doing?
Sorry. My bad, G.
Alright, so there's not much to say about that. We did that scene like 6 or 7 times, and right after the camera cuts, we all just fucking died laughing because the man is just naturally funny, and I'm so glad he was able to like bring his comedic value to the movie and to the music video. It was so funny. And Dax knows what's a trash disc filled with bad jokes, and Dax knows his ass is grass if he lasts his both, and Dax knows it's filled with burn marks from all the coke that he struts the coke that his ass is all alone. Okay, so 3 different uses of the word Dax knows right there. Come on, give me some props. So Dax knows, as in the name of the disc, and Dax knows, like Dax is aware that his ass is grass if he lashes forth. When you say ass is grass, it means you're getting buried. And then Dax knows is filled with the burn marks from all the coke that he snorts to cope that his ass is all alone, basically saying that Dax is on that powder, as Screw would say, because his actions prove so. And we were actually watching a live stream the other night, and he had the drips, and Chase was talking about that, and yeah, so my man Dax is straight up on coke. Like, there's no way he's not. It's just wild. Take your D, chop it off with what's left of your name. Give you this L so you can put it right there in its place. And that's the only way you fly. How's that for wordplay? Okay, so this rhyme scheme is just, I mean, this scheme right here, not the rhyme scheme, but the scheme in itself is fucking nuts. I've seen like 2 or 3 people catch it. Most people catch it in the comments, but like original reactions, I've never seen anybody catch the full thing in the reaction. Screw might have, because I actually texted this diss to Screw like back when the Bad Habit shit was going on, because I was going to say that in Bad Habit, but I decided to leave it out. Basically saying, I'll take your D and chop it off with what's left of your name. If you take the D off of Dax, what's left is axe. So chop his D off, dick, with an axe, or chop the letter D off with an axe. Give you this L, put it right there in its place. Give you this loss to replace the D with an L, which spells out LAX, which, and that's the only way you fly. LAX is the abbreviation for Los Angeles Airport, and Dax lives in LA, saying that's the only way you fly, that's the only way you're gonna be good, because now your name is LAX, Los Angeles Airport. So there's that. Dax, I can promise you that you don't want to play this game. Now you want a bitch that'll rap too fast? So shut the fuck up and listen, Dax. If you even attempt to do what I can, you'll fail like you have as a dad. Oh, snap, that's what you told us, and she cheated again. So either you lied about that, or you're lying about this. Do you even have a kid, or was that shit fabricated from thin air? Trying to get sympathy from a fake story, you fib there. Okay, so that whole thing right there was about a line and she cheated again. Basically saying that he was talking to his ex that cheated again, that didn't actually cheat again. Saying that you and I have a kid that we both know that I'm the father to. And that is completely fucking fabricated, completely and 100% made up. Dax does not have a kid. Dax is not a father. He made it up to try to get sympathy from this fake fucking story. The whole fucking thing is fake. She didn't cheat again. He didn't have a fucking kid. The whole fucking music video, the whole story of that, 100% fake. So when I found out that he was faking having a fucking kid for sympathy and shit, somebody said he said something about it in the Genius interview, which does not make up for it at all. because people were legitimately worried for the man over that song. Like, I went back and watched it, and I was worried about his mental health. I was worried, you know, holy shit, he's got a kid out there. That would fucking suck if I had a kid and couldn't see it. And, like, that would just fucking suck. But the whole fucking thing's made up, so just I can't fucking stand the guy. Producer looking ass, don't face emotionless stiff flares. He's so much of a snake that they took the place of his hair. Okay, so Medusa looking ass, stone faced, emotionless stiff glares. Medusa was a mythological creature, and if she looked at you, your face turned to stone. But I was basically saying his face is like stone face. He has no emotion and stiff glares, and that he's so much of a snake that they took the place of his hair, because Medusa's hair was nothing but snakes, saying that he's Medusa and he's a snake because he's a slimy motherfucker. So that's what that was. Now snap me out of existence like you said that you would. I'll come back with everything I have and that will be good. Do we need to talk about the 9 in 2012 in Nashville? Or maybe refer to it as sucking dick for cash bills? If you know, you know. 7 figures to flex, how quickly bitches forget. You were begging for checks in 2017 to pay rent. Acting so rich, but your apartment ain't even furnished. Fuck a casket, I'ma burn his ass to ashes cause he earned it. Alright, so back in 2017 was the whole thing where he was, like, struggling with his management and didn't have any money and got kicked out of his apartment and shit, and Rez was trying to help him out. I remember back in 2017, he was putting out GoFundMe links to try to get donations to support his first album, not just his rent and shit, so my man was going through it, and basically saying how quickly you forget that you were broke at one point, and now you got 7 figures to flex, and he's, like, flexing on us with all this money. Basically saying, don't forget, Dax, it happened again. You could go back to being broke in a fucking heartbeat. Fuck a casket, I'ma burn his ass to ashes because he earned it. When you burn people in ashes, you put them in urns, but earned and earned it, as it's a double word on the word earn. You guys got that. Kendra cheated, she's not your butler, so she wouldn't wait. But the entire time, you were texting her friend Jay and had the hot for Janae, her old sister, big play. You back at it like a bad habit, being a snake. I did too much research in this. So the Kendra thing about she's not your butler, so she wouldn't wait. Butlers don't wait. And that just coincidentally happens to be her last name, which is, it's like a double entendre with that word. And, you know, she apparently did cheat the first time, sort of, kind of, but definitely did not cheat again. But there's been tweets that I've read and, like, stuff that I've seen where Dax was texting her friend, like, her best friend, Jace. And, or it might be JC, I don't know how to pronounce it, I couldn't really tell, but there was some sketchy stuff going on there, and then her sister, she has a sister named Janae, I think, I don't know, this part was the most speculation of anything. I was just, like, basing it off of tweets and, like, Facebook posts and shit that I read, just trying to infer and, like, connect all the dots. But then, he kind of flipped it on his own thing, that you back at it like a bad habit, being a snake, big play, just using his own terms against him, just funny shit. This shit ain't new to you. You've been a liar your whole life. And got mad at me when I brought you 2 colors to light. Assassinate your character, bitch, I just revealed a shit. When you got 10 different artists with the same story, you're a dick. Okay, so back a couple months ago, I remember Dax put out an Instagram story saying that these guys, like, all of us were trying to assassinate his character. And I remember, like, right then and there, I screenshotted it and I put, I'm not assassinating your character, I'm just revealing your character. You're assassinating yourself. And that's exactly what's going on. And basically saying, when you have 10 different artists with the exact same story, something's not lining up, bro. It's not like we're all making shit up. You are fucking up big time if there's so many people coming out with the literal exact same occurrences and the exact same experiences with you. There's something going on with you. That's just the fact of the matter. You wanna hate on YouTube rappers, but shit, now you need us. People at those shows don't know you, they there for Tech and Nino. So put our names in the title, call it a diss to get those numbers, and don't be a bitch. Someone new to but to another. Okay, basically saying the people at the shows don't know him because he's there, they're there for Technon and stuff like that. Then the probably the most hard-hitting line for him personally is I told him, don't be a bitch, and gave him, like, some SEO algorithmic things to help him with his diss track titles and stuff, saying, put our names in the title, call it a diss, and he might get the 2 million views that he was wanting. And basically told him, don't be a bitch, tips from one YouTuber to another, because he hates being called a YouTuber and a YouTube rapper. I fucking love it. I embrace the shit out of it. It's funny to me, and I love it. This is where I came from, and I'm proud to be a YouTube rapper. Yeah, he fucking hates that, so I knew that would bother him. I don't want nobody fucking with me in these streets. Same children. I don't want nobody fucking with me in these streets. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
I'll be damn. Those are gummy worms.
Classic. Okay, basically, just, I'll be damned, those are gummy worms. Again, like I said, it was a setup from beginning to end. I wanted you guys to think about the gummy worms and just, like, another disc between the music video. And then it's symbolism at the end where I close the casket saying, I'm closing the casket on the situation. We are closing the casket on the situation. We're done with Dax. Like, this is it. Like, we're done with the whole situation. Like, we are all still very confused why he brought this up 5 months later. Like, we were all done talking about this. We were all moved on. Like, nobody liked him, but we were done with the situation, and he just randomly brought it back up. For whatever fucking reason. Last thing is, I want to give a massive shout out to Joey Notto for making this beat. I literally sent him a tweet that I saw one day, and it was the three women singing what you hear in the background. Like, I don't want nobody fucking with me in these streets. Like, they were singing that, and Joey, like, cut it up, sped it up, and made it work with his beat, and just went fucking ham on the beat. Also, fun fact is, I did not like the beat the first time I heard it, because I heard it at, like, 3 a.m., and I was, like, out of my mind and extremely tired, and I was like, it's a good beat, but it's not what I'm wanting. And Joey texted me, he's like, what the fuck, bro? This is a great beat. Like, he was legitimately mad, and he never gets mad, so, like, I listened to it again. I was like, holy shit, this is the perfect beat. What the fuck's going on with me? So I'm glad Joey was persistent on this beat, because it's fucking crazy. But yeah, guys, that is the end of the video. I might throw some bloopers here at the end. I don't know, I've been recording for, like, 30 minutes, so this might be a long video. I might save that for a different video, or give it to Screw or Dwayne, and maybe they can post it if they want to. But you guys will see the bloopers somewhere, because there are a lot of bloopers somewhere around this. But yeah, that's the end of the video, guys. And until next time, it's been your boy, Crypt. Go down to the description below. Pre-save the songs that I've got coming out, please. There are some great songs. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bandana! It's next!